Hey, Brett here with the last edition of this seven-step process of creating an expert empire. You're getting to go behind closed doors and see how I train the audience on how to do that. And in this last step, believe it or not, it's about the marketing. So we wait until this end bit, this last bit, to teach you the marketing, because all the preparation leading up to that is so important, all right? But I'm now going to tell you how to do it in a way where it makes you stand out, but which gets you ridiculous results, all right? Ridiculous results, so that there's no marketing slowdown. Like, as soon as you start marketing, you suddenly realize it doesn't work. That doesn't happen. There's a way of actually marketing where it builds and builds and builds and builds. I'm going to cover that with you in this lesson so that you truly can not only start and build your own expert empire as a coach, a consultant, or an information product marketer, but so not only do all of that, but also have a really thriving business by the end of it that you can rely on, okay? It all ends with the right marketing. This sets it up for success. I hope you enjoy this last lesson very much.
All right, back to the lesson. Number seven, last step, market it like it's your last day on earth. Market your product. This is the only part that will actually matter in the end. The rest is all preparation. Marketing is everything. You cannot help anyone unless you can sell. You cannot help anyone unless you can sell. And if you don't want to sell, then we have a problem. I'm going to address that problem here later on tonight anyway. But selling helps people. Am I helping you so far? Yeah. And I sold you something, yes? And you're getting help from it. I'll talk about it later on. But this is what makes the money. The marketing is what makes the money. The product is actually just a cost to you. The product is the way you hold on to the money. The marketing is what makes the money. It all comes down to how you do the selling. So the very first thing we're doing, the most important experience in your customer's lifetime with you, is the marketing. That's what makes them become customers. Marketing can be as simple as this. If you liked my report, you know, that first thing we offered, the five steps to the five costly mistakes most people make when starting a business, right? If you liked my report, then you might also like my new coaching program. So from your website, the first thing you should offer is some sort of report, some sort of video, some sort of audio, whatever you choose. And then all you have to do, the marketing is simple as this. If you like that, then you might also like this. And they go and read the sales letter or they watch the video, and if they like it, they invest. That's it. You don't have to be scared about marketing or selling. It's actually very step by step. It's actually very simple. If you like this, you might like that. Often Amazon will do it to you, eBay will do it to you. People who like this also like that, and they're trying to sell you other products. It's just how we do it. It's fine, right? Here's something. Anybody here consider themselves a tad boring? Like, if you're boring, do you know you're boring? I don't know. Do you know you're boring? Because I can tell you something. You cannot bore anyone into buying from you. If you have an inkling that you're a tad boring, we've got to address it. Either somebody else should do your marketing, or you've got to find out how to be more exciting. Because passion, excitement, heart, emotion is what people like. Particularly like to watch things that touch their heart. And you can't bore people into buying from you. You could have the best program in the world. If your marketing is boring, forget about it. Forget about it. Who's ever been in a seminar where the speaker's really boring? Yes. Not my seminar, hopefully, right? But you know those seminars, right? You go, oh, please. It's like you're in jail for the whole day. Like, give me a break, right? You cannot bore anyone into buying from. You have to be excited, be passionate. You have to be. If you're not a passionate person, find a way to be passionate. I bet there's something you're passionate about. I often have people saying, oh, Brett, I'm just sort of a quiet person, I'm shy. Ah, come on, come on. There are times when you're not shy. Everybody has times when they find that passion. And if you can't or you don't, you better find it. Don't enter this business if you're not going to be passionate about what you're doing. Don't even start. If you're afraid of selling, give me a break. Here's why you should give me a break. Because in an audience like this, about 50% of people do not like selling. Statistically, I know it to be true. I ask audiences. I know what the data is. Half of any audience doesn't like selling. But yet you want to make money. Anybody have a problem? Anybody see the problem there at all? But hold on. You do realize that every single person here is selling something, don't you? You do realise that, right? Who's actually in a job here? You actually in a job? Hands up for me. Yeah. So all you folks are selling your time to your employer. You know that, right? You're selling your time to your employer. They pay you an hourly rate, and you're selling it to your employer. And if they don't like the rate you're charging, they don't hire you. Or it might come to a stage where whatever they're paying you, they don't think it's a good deal anymore, so they stop paying you. And they tell you to go somewhere else. You've got to sell yourself to somebody else. Everybody here is selling something already. So don't tell me you're afraid of selling. You're already selling. True or true? And there are people who don't like people getting up on stage to sell. Yet they're showing you how to make money, how to sell. Oh, I don't like them selling on stage to devalue the whole seminar. Hold on, you're selling in your job. You're selling yourself to your employer. And you don't like people selling to you? And you don't like them selling to you when they're showing you how to sell to others? Who wants customers to pay them here? Anybody want customers to pay the money here at all? Oh, interesting. How about you got to sell to them? And they're going to get good value. True or true? They're going to get good value. If they don't get good value, you give them their money back. But there has to be a transaction happening here, right? So your marketing, here's something to remember, always. Your marketing always. And it should be automatic. And I'm going to show you how to make it automatic. Don't worry. Always and automatic. From this day forward, you're always marketing, always marketing, always marketing, always showing people how you can help them. Go and get my report. Go and watch my video. Here's some tips. Here's some information. Always marketing. It's the only thing that matters. When you stop marketing, you slow down your income. You don't stop your income, you usually slow it down. If you want to get a raise right now in your job, you've got to go talk to your employer, see if you can get a raise per hour. When you've got your own business as an expert, all you do is run more marketing. You want to earn more money? Just run more marketing. That's it. Let more people know about what it is you do. That's it. Here's your 7 steps, just so we're clear. Choose your niche. Find your audience's problems. Create your unique solution. Stake your claim. Create a website. Create your product. And market like it's your last day on earth. Good or good? That's the system, right? That's the system with a bit of detail in between. Some points I want to make you aware of. Whilst you don't have to be the best, your content has to be great. So I am openly telling you, you do not need to be the best in your industry. Some people hesitate doing this because you think, oh, I'm not the best, and I don't know if I could compete with XYZ. He's too good. She's too great. You don't have to be the best. But your content has to be great. So when people do invest with you, they actually win. All right? But you personally don't have to be the best. This should make it a lot easier for a lot more people. Now, I am not the best in the world at internet marketing. I'm not the best in the world at speaking. But I do the best I can. And it seems to work. And if I'd have waited until I became the best in the world, I'd be waiting forever. True or true? You don't have to be the best, folks, right? Your content just needs to be great. You work hard at the content, people get rewarded. I want you to make it your goal to enrich and inspire people. Like, leave this world a better place. I know you've got a message. There's something inside you which you need to share. There's something inside you. And you can actually do something for the world. You actually can. So why not make it your goal to inspire others? It's one of the best things you can do. Who wants to inspire people here? Please raise your hand. Yeah, awesome. You should. You should. You must. Leave this planet having squeezed the life out of it, given some value, and you know, and have people really caring that you're not there anymore. Like, really, like, wow, that person left a legacy. That person was great. Because you've actually spent your life doing something worthwhile. You've inspired. You've enriched people's lives. They win or they win. I try and always make it that if whether you invest with me or not, you win. You've got some value. Like, no one's ever forced to spend any money at my events. If you choose to, awesome. If you don't, you had a great time and you learnt some stuff. You walk away better off. Yes or yes? That's how it's got to be. Otherwise, don't do it. Teach people so well they become independent of you. The key word there is independent. Teach people so well that they become independent of you. And I know presenters and experts, I know them very, very well, who do not follow this philosophy. They do not agree with me, and quite frankly, I'm okay with that. They want to have a tribe, a herd of people following them around like the Pied Piper. I get the concept. That's not my goal, though. My goal is if you're with me, my goal is you become so good at what you do, you can fly on your own. So if I'm not there, you're okay. To me, that's a much better use of my time and my effort. I want you to be independent. And not always thinking, well, I better ask Brett. No, you should know the answer. I should be able to teach you so you know what I would say if I was there and what your heart tells you. Often, I run coaching where people can actually phone me up. It's very rare. And one of my students used to say, he'd go to ring me to ask me a question. He'd pick it up and go, I know what he's going to say. Bang, he'd write the answer. Because I trained him to think in a certain way where he knew the answer himself. He could ask the question of himself that I was going to ask him. He'd know the answer. Off he went. Become my best student yet. So create the independence. I don't want you to be reliant on me or anyone. I want you to be independent. Realize that not everyone will actually love what you do. This can actually be a shock for many people. When someone invests with you, you can have people who do not ask for their money back, but yet do not love what you do. And they almost hold a grudge sometimes too. It's like, I'm in his program. Yeah. It's okay. That's going to happen. It's going to happen. As hard as you try to please everyone, is that possible? No. You already know it's not possible. And even with people who invest with you, it's not always possible either. But you've got to learn to accept that and be, all right, I'm going to try my best. And who's responsible? Who's ultimately responsible for someone else's happiness? Them, right? And I have people come into my program, earn tons of money. I've got people come into my program, earn no money. My information's the same every time. Our help, our mission, our goal, our efforts, the same every time. But unfortunately, it comes down to you, yes? It comes down to how you apply it, whether you're a person who blames or whether you take responsibility, whether you whinge or not, whether you ask the question of what doesn't work or whether you answer it or not with what if it does. Same for your customers. Under-promise and over-deliver wherever you possibly can. Don't tell them everything you're going to give them. Under-promise, over-deliver. Psychologically, it works every time. People love that. They love being over-delivered on. Always keep a little surprise in your pocket. Don't tell people the surprise, otherwise it's not a surprise anymore. Yes. All right. I'm going to tell you about my one philosophy, all right? I have a philosophy, and it's just sort of grown over time, that you only ever need to focus on how many things?
One.
One thing. Only ever at any one time is one thing. The one thing will take you naturally to the second thing, all right? If you want massive success, and this is how I've been able to achieve, honestly, it's a secret behind a lot of my success is this one here. Focus on the one thing you need to do now, you'll naturally be led to the next thing and the next thing and the next. Yet, so many people do the opposite. They want to see the whole big picture. They want me to draw out a whole mind map. Show me everything. And when you show them everything, what does that actually do to our brain?
Overwhelm.
Overwhelm. And overwhelm, we don't take action. Focus on the one thing. Like you might look at my 7-step plan, you might think, oh shit, that's 7 steps. No, think about step one. We'll worry about step two when we? We'll worry about step two when we? Yeah, there, you know this, yeah. But are you living it? Are you doing it? One, just one thing, one thing, one thing. We can handle one thing. In fact, that's what I use the tennis ball in during seminars. You probably see me do it. I throw a whole bunch of tennis balls at one person to see if they can catch them all. And they can't catch them. They might catch one if they're lucky, sometimes two. And then I ask the audience, what if I was to throw these tennis balls one after the other? Would that be better? And everyone goes, yeah, they'd be able to catch more tennis balls. Why? Because our brain can only focus on one thing. So that's my one philosophy. I want you to take it with you if you possibly can. Some people can't handle it because they want to do everything at once. Okay. It'll be a lot easier. It'll be a lot more successful. Just focus on one thing at a time. Worry about the rest after you finish this step. All right.